Bangalore surroundings have over 240 species of birds. You look around here for an hour, you will get about 20 species of birds in the mini forest. There is a whole variety of snakes, there are squirrels, there are palm civets. All those count as wildlife.
We are near the mini forest in JP Nagar, Bengaluru, with Deepa Mohan, a birder and a wildlife volunteer who conducts educational walks for children and adults alike on urban wildlife.
I have been conducting open walks for BNG Birds, which is the umbrella birding group in Bangalore, for many years. Fourth Sunday of every month, it's open for everybody. So the idea is to introduce both children and adults to the many green spaces and the forest spaces that we have.
Once Bengaluru's claim to fame, green spaces in the city have been shrinking over decades, and the ones that have survived are being increasingly closed off to people, citing law and order issues. This led to Deepa Mohan to begin a campaign to open up green spaces in Bengaluru.
There is some merit, because if people are interested in learning something about nature, especially even taking children out there or youngsters out there, it's a valuable experience, for the simple reason that the largest body of tomorrow's manpower, technical manpower, is going to come from today's cities.
Bengaluru holds the dubious distinction of closing off access to neighborhood parks during the day. During the pandemic, many birders found their usual spots like Valley School and the Thurahalli Forest closed off. While neighborhood parks are maintained by the BBMP, the Thurahalli Forest, a 590-acre green spot, comes under the Forest Department. With cycling trails, the urban forest was a popular destination among birders and other city dwellers.
Well, first and the foremost thing, during the lockdown itself, people stayed back indoors. And because of a drastic fall in the footfall, even the biodiversity and the faunal diversity had returned to Thurahalli. And there are recorded instances of almost close to 125 species of birds, some of them coming from as far as Israel and Egypt in Thurahalli, that has been documented. And at the same time, it is also a place where peacocks thrive. And peacock is a Schedule 1 species. It's also a national animal which is protected by the law. And with an increasing footfall, naturally, this is going to fall. That could really create a situation of local extinction for these birds there, and also the small mammals in the area, like the hare and the rabbits and all those animals, yes.
However, Thurahalli has now caught the eye of the CM Yediyurappa and is one among the city forests that has found a mention in his Bengaluru Mission 2022 plan to be developed into a tree park. This move is being opposed by the local volunteers. An earth mover spotted in one of the entrances at Thurahalli on February 2nd has led to spontaneous protests in the area. Interestingly, a mini tree park of around 35 acres has already been developed in Thurahalli.
The reason we are creating the tree park by the side, the 35 odd acres of Thurahalli forest, minor forest, on that side into a tree park, was to veer the people away from the forest into the tree park. They wanted people to engage with nature in the tree park by the side. For the very same reason, they created all kinds of infrastructures, including a ticket counter and a compounded wall. And they also had a gazebo there, and they had benches installed, and they had name plaques put out there. They had made pathways for people to walk. Everything has been put in place, but that tree park stands underutilized. Why now a bigger tree park?
Maybe Bengaluru can learn a thing or two from Delhi, whose urban forest patches have managed to strike a balance between the needs of the public and nature without falling to the trap of commercialization. South Delhi's Sanjay Van, spread over 786 hectares, has been developed by the Delhi Development Authority. In city forests across Delhi, trees are largely left wild after having been nurtured for the first few years.
What we need today is not a very manicured garden, but a more wilder, rustic garden. And if such a people object to something becoming a little wild and less manicured, that means they are not being sensitive to having urban wildlife. So to believe and have a close cut lawn that every place should look like a golf course is ridiculous.
With the tree cover shrinking every year, it is important that urban forests are allowed to thrive in cities like Bengaluru. At the same time, access to green spaces like parks and lakes need to become easier. Only then can a city balance the needs of its human as well as urban wildlife.